Hello students, welcome back to the new mathematics session. We have completed half of the syllabus and the first terminal examination. Congratulations to everyone for performing well in the exams. So today we will be learning about the 9th chapter, that is ratio and proportion. So this is the mind map for today's class. We will start by learning about the meaning of the term ratio and its properties. Then we will learn how to reduce a ratio in the simplest form. We will learn about equivalent ratios and how to compare ratios. Then we will learn about the second part of the chapter, that is the meaning of proportion, how to find the missing terms in a proportion. Finally, we will learn about unitary method and learn how to solve word problems using unitary method. So students, here we have two students named Amit and Shivam. They both had a magical bowl of candies. So whenever they asked for candies, the bowl used to give them. So when Amit used to ask for the candies, the bowl gave 2 candies. But when Shivam used to ask, the bowl gave 6 candies. The bowl is a bit biased towards Shivam, right? How many candies did Shivam get more than Amit? Let's find out. Shivam got 6 candies and Amit got 2. So 6 minus 2, that is 4. Shivam got 4 more candies than Amit. Is there any other way to compare the candies? Let's try to compare the candies with the help of division. So let's divide the greater number by the smaller number. So when we divide 6 by 2, we get the answer as 3. So we can say that Shivam has 3 times more candies than Amit, right? So when we compare two quantities of the same kind using division, it is known as ratio. We use the symbol of colon to depict ratio and it is read as is2. So here in the above example, we have to find the ratio of the Shivam candies to Amit candies. So the number of candies with Shivam are 6. And we will write it in the fraction form. The number of candies with Amit is 2. So 6 by 2, we will simplify it. It becomes 3 by 1. So we will write it as 3 is 2, 1. The numerator will be the first part and the denominator will be the second part. So in general, the ratio between two numbers A is to B, where A and B are not equal to 0. That means the numerator and the denominator should not be equal to 0. The first term is known as antecedent and the second term is known as the consequent. Now let's learn about properties of a ratio. The first property, a ratio exists between two quantities of the same kind. That means a ratio can exist between a length and a length, but it cannot exist between time and distance. Second, a ratio is always expressed in its simplest or the lowest form. Now we will learn about how to express a ratio in its lowest form in the next part. Third, to find the ratio between two quantities, they must be expressed in the same unit. Now what is the difference between same kind and same unit? Same kind means it can be length and length. That means you can find the ratio between 20 centimeter and 2 meters because centimeter and meter are a type of length. But you cannot find the ratio between 20 kgs and 5 hours because the kind varies. Now how to find the ratio between two different units? So here I have 102 centimeters and 2 meters. First I will convert either meter into centimeter or centimeter into meter. Now to convert meter into centimeter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 2 meters is equal to 200 centimeter. Now I can compare 102 centimeter and 200 centimeter. Fourth property, the order in a ratio is very important. The ratio A is to B cannot be written as B is to A. Last, a ratio has no unit. Now let's learn how to convert a ratio in its simplest form. Now similar to a fraction, a ratio is said to be in its lowest form when the terms of a ratio, that is antecedent and the consequent, have no common factor other than 1. So here we have a question which says convert 36 is to 42 in its simplest form. The first step, write the ratio in the form of a fraction, that is 36 by 42. Now we will divide the numerator and the denominator by the HCF of 36 and 42. So the HCF of 36 and 42 is 6. Now let's divide it. So 36 by 42, we have to divide it by 6 because 6 is the SCF of 36 and 42. So 36 divided by 6 is 6 and 42 divided by 6 is 7. Now we know that 6 and 7 have no common factor other than 1. So now 36 is to 42 has been converted in its simplest form, that is 6 by 7. Now we will write it in the form of a ratio, that is 6 is to 7. Now let's learn how to find equivalent ratios. Now how we used to find equivalent fractions, the same procedure is used to find equivalent ratios. Now how do we find equivalent fractions? Yes, we either multiply or divide the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So here we have a question that says, find two equivalent ratios of 5 is to 6. Now to find equivalent ratios, I said we either multiply or divide the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So let's multiply 5 by 6 by 2. So we get 10 by 12. Now the question says find 2. So we have already found one equivalent ratio. Now let's find the next equivalent ratio. So I can divide 5 by 6 by any number, by 3, 4, 5, any number by your wish. I'm multiplying 5 by 6 by 3. So I get 15 by 6, 3s are 18. Now we will write the fraction in the form of a ratio. So 10 by 12 can be written as 10 is to 12. And 15 by 18 will be written as 15 is to 18. So we can say that the ratios 5 is to 6, 10 is to 12 and 15 is to 18 are equivalent ratios. Now let's learn how to compare two ratios. So here we have a question which says compare 5 is to 6 and 4 is to 7. The first step is that you have to write the ratio in the form of a fraction. So 5 is to 6 is written as 5 by 6 and 4 is to 7 is written as 4 by 7. Now remember the concept of comparison of fractions. Here we have two fractions and these are unlike fractions. Now how to convert an unlike fraction into a like fraction? Yes, first we will find the LCM of the denominators. So LCM of 6 and 7 will be 42. Yes, now to make these unlike fractions into like fractions, first I will multiply 5 by 6 by 7 by 7 so that I get the denominator as 42. Now 5 sevens are 35. Coming to the next fraction, 4 by 7. Now I will multiply 4 by 7 by 6 by 6 to get the denominator as 42. So 7 6 are 42 and 4 6 are 24. Right? Now we got two fractions with same denominators, that is 35 by 42 and 24 by 42. Now when the denominators are same, we can compare the numerators. So when I compare the numerators, 35 is greater than 24. Yes, so I can say that 35 by 42 is greater than 24 by 42, which means the ratio 5 by 6 is greater than 4 by 7. So let's convert it into the ratio form, that is 5 is to 6 is greater than 4 is to 7. So we follow the same procedure as we used to compare two fractions. Now students, let's consider a situation where Rahul bought 3 pencils for rupees 30 and Ritu bought 5 pencils for rupees 50. Now who bought the pencils at a cheaper price? Now to find that, let's first find the ratio between the number of pencils bought by Rahul to the number of pencils bought by Ritu. So Rahul bought 3 pencils and Ritu bought 5 pencils. So we got the ratio 3 is to 5. Next, let's find the ratio of the cost paid for 3 pencils and the cost paid for 5 pencils. So Rahul paid rupees 30 and Ritu paid rupees 50. Now, is 30 and 50 in the simplest form? No, right? So when we reduce 30 and 50 in the simplest form, we get 3 is to 5. Now, the ratio of the number of pencils is equal to the cost paid for the pencil. That is 3:5 is equal to 3:5. So when two ratios are equal, we say that the ratios are in proportion. Now what is the symbol used for proportion? We use double colons to express a proportion. So I can write this as 3:5 as to 3:5. We read proportion as 2. So I will say that 3:5 as to ₹30 is to ₹50. So neither Rahul nor Ritu paid an extra amount. Both paid same amount for the pencils bought by them. Now, in a statement of proportion, the first and the last terms are known as extremes or extreme terms, and the second and the third term are known as means or means terms. So here we can say that A and D are the extreme terms and B and C are the mean terms. Now there is another way to find that whether two ratios are in proportion or not. Now what is that? When the product of the extremes is equal to the product of the means, we can say that two ratios are in a proportion. Now with this generalized formula, you can find any missing term in the given proportion. Now you would have come across a situation where you visited a stationery shop to buy 3 colored pens. But there the shopkeeper tells you that a pack of 6 colored pens costs ₹30. Now how will you calculate the amount you have to pay for 3 colored pens? So when a value of a certain quantity is given and you want to find a value of many more or less quantity, we use unitary method. Now what is the meaning of unitary? Unitary means 1. So when we have to find the value of many more or less quantity from the value of given quantity, we first find the value of one quantity, and with the help of the value of one quantity, we find the value of many more or less quantity. That is known as unitary method. Now students, in the example we discussed, we know that price of 6 colored pens is ₹30. First we will find the price of one colored pen. That will be 30 divided by 6. Now how did we get 30 divided by 6? There is a formula that says total value of the given item divided by number of items. So the total value was 30, and we had the value of 30 for 6 items. So 30 divided by 6. So when we divide 30 by 6, we get 5. So the price for one colored pen is ₹5. Now we can find the price for 3 colored pens. That will be 3 into 5, that is 15. So the amount paid for 3 colored pens will be ₹15. So students, in today's session we learned about the meaning of ratio, that is comparing two things using division. Then we learned about properties of a ratio, that is we can find ratio between two quantities of the same kind. The order of the terms in a ratio is very important, that is A is to B cannot be written as B is to A, and a ratio has no unit. Then we learned how to compare two ratios, how to find equivalent ratios, right? Next we learned about the second part of the chapter, that is proportion and the parts of a proportion or the terms of a proportion, that were means and extremes. We also learned a relation between means and extremes, that was the product of extremes should be equal to the product of means. Finally, we learned about unitary methods, that is to find the value of many more or less things with the value of the given quantities. Thank you, students.